In this video presentation, we're going to look at those very early skills my students need to master in order to terminate a PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable. So we're going to actually strip off the outside PVC and terminate the ends of the copper conductors, line, neutral and circuit protective conductor. We've already seen a series of videos where Joe's gone through the construction, the sizes and the variants of them. So this video is all about the basic skills in order to turn the end over, in other words, double the end over. We're going to be using a fixed blade knife in the presentation, a set of side cutters and a set of pliers, and we'll be introducing the green and yellow sleeving onto the circuit protective conductor. I understand there are tools out there to make the job a lot easier, but we're going old school in this video. Let's terminate the end next. So following on from Joe in the classroom, I'm going to show you once again how to terminate the ends of a PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable. This is college way. I understand there are tools that make it considerably easier. However, when learners come to us, often their dexterity and hand skills are very weak. So therefore we go back old school. I'm going to terminate using a knife, pair of pliers and side cutters. So we take our PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable, and this is 1 mm². I'm going to come down approximately 150mm down, and we're going to take our knife and we're going to score around the outside PVC, not saw, so it won't be on the bench and we'll be pressing rather firmly into it. We'll actually just score around the cable at approximately 150mm. So score around, top side, side, bottom, side. So I've scored around the cable all the way around with my knife. I'm next going to turn the cable around and I'll take my side cutters. So I'm going to take my side cutters. This is quite important. We're just going to use the cutting action here. This is the bit my students find the most difficult, is that when they put it on here, they're too excited about cutting into it and then make a poor effort at the first cut. I usually make it look incredibly easy and it isn't, to get it in the right position. So using that as the line on the cable, so put it in the center and just take a moment to see it's fully in and we're dead straight before we actually do the cutting action, like so. Now what I do is I separate my conductors out, so I'm holding on to the two live conductors, line and neutral, and leaving the bare CPC in the center. I'm now going to hold on to those conductors and roll my knuckles out. So as I do that, it will pull down the conductors, opening it out. So let's see that in action. So I hold on to my two conductors, in this case line and neutral, and I just roll my knuckles out like so. Once I've got it started, I'm going to pull it down just short of the area which is scored before breaking off the outside PVC. It gets easier the further we are away from it, so we're almost there now. So I'm going to move my hands down and go a little slower and pull it just short of that scored area. Now we peel off the outside PVC. You might see the white powder on here, which is French chalk. Take off both sides of the mechanical protection and I'm going to pull it away like so. Hopefully we can see we've got a nice clear clean cut around the outside PVC and we haven't cut into the PVC of the conductors themselves. So we've exposed our conductors. Just to remind you what Joe went through, blue is our neutral, brown is our line, and the bare conductor, which we'll identify, is our CPC. We're going to terminate the ends next. So what we're going to do now is terminate the ends of our conductor. So I'm going to double over the line conductor, the neutral conductor, and we're going to oversleeve and double over the circuit protective conductor as well. We're going to take our knife and we're going to come down about 2 cm and press a little bit firm around the thermoplastic PVC insulation around the conductors. We know from Joe's video that has a maximum operating temperature of 70 degrees C. We are not actually going to terminate these into anything, it's just practicing those hand skills. So I'm going to set the distance down at approximately 20 mm or 2 cm down for each of our conductors. We take our knife again and at approximately 20 mm, press a lot firmer this time, all the way around, and hopefully it means we can just pull off the PVC insulation on the conductors themselves. Remember, the conductors are made of copper. So if we do both, I'm going to use it to line up for the other one. So I'm going to use the line and neutral to use it as a reference point so we get them the same length, like so. Press again firmer with the knife. Around we go. And hopefully it will just pull away. Take our pliers next. And we're going to hold, in this case, approximately slightly less than half the copper. So I've got approximately slightly less than half the copper here and slightly more than half of the copper conductor showing here. The reason being it will bend around the circumference or the side part of the pliers. Let's see that in action. So I'm going to take it from there and just hold that tightly, take it from there and fold it over. And then I've moved my pliers and I've come now to the top side and I'm going to squeeze up that gap like so. And we've doubled over the conductors. Of course, I've managed to find the best pair of pliers we haven't got at our college, so there's not a lot of grip in these. So I'll try the other one. Take the line conductor. I'm going to take approximately half of it again. So approximately just less than half here, slightly more than half there. Fold it around the circumference of the pliers. Squeeze up that gap. And we've doubled over both the line conductor and the neutral conductor of almost equal doubling over. Let's look at the CPC next. So we've terminated the line conductor, the brown one, the neutral being the blue conductor, and now we've got our bare center conductor. And from Joe's videos, we know that is our circuit protective conductor. We need to identify terminations by using green and yellow sleeving. So if I make that approximately the same length as the PVC on the live conductors, and snip that off, I can just slide that over onto the conductor itself, and now I can look at terminating this one over. It's probably a fraction long at the moment, so if I just trim it back a little bit, and we'll use exactly the same method as we did before. Slightly less than half in the pliers, slightly more than half this side. Fold first, remove the pliers, squeeze the gap up. Again, the pliers aren't the best, but they're the ones you've got to use, so I must be able to do it if you can do it. I've doubled over the conductor. So we've got the CPC doubled over, we've got the blue neutral doubled over, and the brown line conductor doubled over using a technique we expect you to master within the first couple of weeks of being at college. I hope this video has been some help.